It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, co-founder and chief investment officer of Payne Capital Management. Now, this week on the Street of Dreams, the good news and the good times continue to roll with the Commerce Department's announcement of an upward revision of the second quarter GDP to an annual rate of 4.2% from an earlier estimate of 4.1%. In addition, U.S. corporate profits measured a 16.1% gain year over year. Now, this is the largest in 6 years. Of course, it was boosted by the tax cuts and a stronger economic growth than initially reported. Now, small company stocks made all-time record highs this week and are outperforming their larger company counterparts, with earnings growth of 35% from last year, and with the Small Business Optimism Index climbing to its second highest reading in its 45-year history, as business owners expect the strong economy to continue. Joining the Russell 2000, that's the Small Company Stock Index, on the new high list were the S&P 500, the Russell 1000, the Russell 3000, and the Wilshire 5000 indices. The New York Stock Exchange Advanced Decline Line, the NASDAQ, and the Value Line Geometric and Arithmetic indices. Now, this all sounds good, especially when you hear it on the evening news that the market is making an all-time record high. But when you look at your statement, you might be a little confused, since the previous highs were made this past January, when the market made a short-term peak and the majority of the gains were made for the year. See, the market is just getting back to even, coming out of a seven-month consolidation from this past January. But historically, when the stock market makes new highs after a period of consolidation, it's proved to be very bullish. Of course, bull markets climb a wall of worry, and the media has plenty of issues they want you to focus on. But see, markets don't care about good or bad. They only care about better or worse. And things continue to get better as a whole, with the second longest economic expansion in the history of our country.